this is a nodular growth. You see, this is pedunculated, and most commonly clinically these are diagnosed as fibroepithelial polyp. Sometimes it may be lipoma also. So after excision we'll be doing histopathological examination and we'll confirm the diagnosis. Now here you see, this is pedunculated, it's attached with the skin through a small pedicle, and we'll have to excise from the pedicle this mass, and there will be a feeder artery, a single feeder artery. It will be a small feeder artery, and we'll have to restore the feeder artery, and then we'll be excising the mass, and we'll be doing it under local anesthesia. Here we'll be infiltrating anesthesia like this. Okay, subcutaneous field in all directions. We'll be infiltrating the anesthesia in all directions with a single prick. We'll not take out the needle and we'll not make multiple pricks. So anesthesia was infiltrated, hardly 0.5 ml anesthesia is required. We'll wait for some time. One feeder artery is there, so we'll be giving hemostatic suture, but we'll not tighten the suture. Hey, so here this is a pass string type of suture we are placing here. If the bleeding occurs, then to restore the bleeder. Will not tighten the suture. Give small incision on the base like this. Now we'll be excising the mass. Start from here. See, there will be an evidence of mild bleeding. Not here. A significant bleeding is not there. So the mass is excised. Okay. This is the mass. And residual skin is there. No need to suture this skin since this is a very small wound, or you can give one single stitch. Passing suture is not required. So I'm removing the suture. Better you give a mattress suture, that will be easier for removing the stitch. So the operation is over.